Hey everybody, welcome back to the Chaotic Little Book Corner. I am in a different location right now. Well, I'm still in front of my bookshelf, but I'm at a different angle because it's a lot happening in this room right now. As always, it's chaotic. Wow, the outpour of love and support and questions that I have received, it's kind of incredible. This is the morning after I posted my Q&A announcement. I am going to turn the Q&A into a two-parter. So this one's going to be earlier in the week and the other one will come either later on in the week or next week. Because I can't begin to explain how many questions I've received. And I'm so happy because I really think that the best way, and I'll start with one of the questions that I received, and that was, how do you support someone with DID? And I think for me, for me, the support comes when you listen and you're interested in the experience and you're not willing to shut down and just pretend that the experience isn't different for somebody with mental health issues even. But for DID, I'm going to start with the basic questions. But kind of like spun through the whole ordeal. So let's begin first actually with an explanation of what DID is. Dissociative Identity Disorder, formerly called Multiple Personality Disorder. Why did they change it? Well, there's so much stigma revolving around the idea of multiple personality disorder because it's a really scary, it's a scary disorder to have and to experience, but also to think about. Nobody wants to think about the fact that somebody that they love has multiple existing planes in themselves. DID can be in a person. It usually starts in a person between the ages of about 3 to 7, and it starts because of a trauma that causes the brain to become so traumatized. So that means that if I had not developed DID, I would have had a psychotic episode at the age of probably 4 or 5, instead of being able to continue on at my age. I was 5 the first time I remember experiencing my DID symptoms. So the first time that I remember acknowledging the voices, I was 5 years old and I was talking to this little girl. And we were just talking and I said, well, what does your conscience tell you? And she's like, what are you talking about? And I was like, you know, that little voice inside your head. And she was like, what? And I was like, no, the voices in your head. What are they telling you to do? And that was the end of my social life. So I've had it for years. I was bullied severely as a child, and that exacerbated the DID and caused more parts to form. And then I was sexually assaulted at the age of 13, and then again at the age of 21, and then again at the age of 23. All different people, but still happened. And that continued to exacerbate the DID, causing me to form about 52 parts. So each part holds either a memory or an emotion. There are EPs and ANPs, apparently normal parts, and EPs are emotional parts. Emotional parts usually range in ages about 3 to 15, and then from 15 up, you have your apparently normal parts, who can act as a person forward, and they know how to behave, and they have certain rules and regulations that they understand to appear normal so that the outside world doesn't perceive them as a threat. Or doesn't try and threaten them. So the parts act as amnesic barriers. Now, an amnesic barrier is formed and spaced between the host, myself, and memories that are traumatizing that could cause the psychotic break. The amnesic barriers that are in place are there to protect the host from said problems. But they are also there to control and to give stability to the system. So, for me, as a person with DID, I was never screened specifically for DID until later on in life when they thought I had schizophrenia. So, on and off, I've been in psychiatric care. I've been in... So these amnesic barriers are in place for the safety of the host. Now, so the movie Split. I did see one comment, and that explained to me that this character was based on a true life character who was a rapist and a kidnapper. Okay, let's begin with a couple of statements here. First of all, we are using rape and kidnapping as a form of entertainment. Problem. We can argue that the idea of Split is to start a conversation and to give credibility to my disorder and others. But what does it really do? Well, it definitely stirred some questions in some of you, because some of you have admitted to me that you've seen the film. And you came away with a lot of questions. Now, in my experience, most of the DID people that I've come into contact with are violent towards themselves. They're not violent towards others. And if they are violent towards others, it's an isolated incident and it's focused in by a trauma or a trigger. A trigger would be a situation that would cause one of the apparently normal parts or emotional parts to come out and try and protect the host. So, for example, let's say that a man is walking down the road and he has been sexually assaulted at a very young age by a man with brown hair. And he sees a man with brown hair trying to grab a young girl. Well, he may not put two and two together that that might be their father and a young child. He may not even experience anything. He'll see brown hair and his attacker, and he will try to either... He will either be triggered in a way where he starts to have an emotional response and a traumatic response to this moment, because he will see his attacker harming someone else, or he will try and save this young child and not understand the context. But his initial reason for that moment is trauma, and it's not out of anything except for pure emotion of fear for his life and his safety, anger for his childhood being lost, and just dismay and depression for the fact that he has this experience in his background. Now, the host of the part that has now seen this man with brown hair and believes that there is danger, the host will no longer experience that moment. The host will be taken back into the system and will experience nothing of this moment. And the host will not be allowed to come back out to front until the moment has passed and safety is reestablished. And that is what a switch and a amnesic spell or amnesic like space would look like. That's another big issue, is that when we bring DID into the forefront and the center, and we make it an entertainment fact in the movie Split, we lose credibility. Because in any moment where we try and cause entertainment out of a mental illness, we lose credibility. Because they start to think that it's something that's entertainment and we're trying to be fun and trendy. And I can definitely see this boat movie causing a trend in the DID community, and it really saddens me, because DID is not something to be played around with, and it's really, really terrifying. So how many parts do I have? I have 52. I have 52 parts. They range from the age of 3 to 35. I have both male, female, and non-gendered. I have, I have female, non-gendered, female, non-gendered, male, and trans inside. And I also have, I have straight, lesbian, and asexual within myself as well. So I range in gender, age, sexuality, and I also range in, how do I explain this? Physical form. They all believe that they have a different physical appearance than I do. So I have redheads, brown hair, black hair. I have one who's bald. I don't really understand why she shaved her head, but I'm not going to argue it. So, green eyes, blue eyes, red, brown. Basically, these parts all have knowledge of themselves as a separate entity to myself, so therefore they have their own identity in general. How do I feel during a switch? I don't know how to explain that. It's not an easy explanation, because if it was, I would tell people and it would make more sense. I feel lightheaded, like dark comes over me, it also depends on who's coming out. With Amy, who is one of my EPs, she is a younger part, she is 5. The whole world kind of goes blurry. And with her, I have some communication and I'm able to register and understand what she's doing, which means that I have some control over what I see and what I hear. I can't control the body and I can't control what comes out of my mouth, but I can hear and understand what's coming out of my mouth. So that's one type of switch. And then another type of switch is when a completely separate part comes out that I either have no control over or I have very little communication with. If they come out, then I will go into myself and I will feel darkness, and I will come out and have missed an hour to two, sometimes a week, the longest time being a month. And then there are parts that I have absolutely no idea that they even exist. And those parts are the scariest, because I physically just lose everything. Like, I lose sense of time, of existence. I have no... It feels like I've been placed within a closet, and I have no room to move my hands, arms, and feet, and my mouth is bound, and my ears are shut, and I can't physically be aware of anything. It's really terrifying, and that is the scariest type of switch. So when that happens, and it happens less now because I have so much more awareness of my parts, but that is the scariest type of switch, and when it does happen, it destroys me for about a week. Do I dislike any of my parts? No. Absolutely not. I have the way having DID is like being a pie. You're in an apple pie, and the pie can get cut as many times as it needs to, but it's still one whole pie that started as one whole pie. And so you can't just disregard one of the pieces of the pie and pretend that it doesn't exist, because it always was there. It might get eaten, but then you're missing a piece, and so you're not a whole pie anymore. So you need each piece of that pie. So that's really how I consider it, is each part of myself has a purpose. They have a reason for being who they are. I have parts that are self-harming. I have parts that are severely anorexic or severely bulimic. I have parts that have mental health issues on their own. I have parts that are severely OCD. I have parts that are allergic to milk. And I don't dislike any of them. I think I get frustrated the most with the ones who self-harm, and I get frustrated with the most with the ones who have a different sense of reality, but I don't dislike any of them because that's like disliking myself. Do they all have names? No. Some of them identify only as non-gender, one of them in particular. He identifies, well, I call him a he because he started out, so it started off as a he and it morphed into a them, and then it became an it, and it became an it when we started doing more in-depth therapy, and it started identifying itself as Shu, which was an inanimate object, and then once we discussed with it more thoroughly in therapy and had a group meeting and a what we call conference, it identified itself as an it, not a them or a they. And ever since then, it's just been an it, and it has no name. So there are also parts that only stay distinctly inside and they never come out and never function in the real world. They are merely there to witness the inside and internal experience. They also hold memories or traumas, and therefore they can only be triggered if the trauma occurs, which it may be that the smell of a perfume is a trauma for that one particular part. And if I never smell that perfume again, that part will never be triggered again. So it will never come out. And therefore, it doesn't really have a name because its identity is fully based on a fragrance. It's really complicated. What's the one thing I wish people would understand about me? I'm not a danger. I'm not dangerous. And I'm not faking. I think if I could get everybody in the world to understand I'm not dangerous and I'm not faking, I would feel a lot better. But I say that, and then, you know, I feel like as much as I wish I could kind of control what people think of me, I don't think that's fair, and I don't think that's okay. And I think that you need people with different opinions of your experience to really understand your own experience. So I don't really, I think it would really just be to know that I'm safe and I'm not gonna hurt you. Because I have so many people who get nervous about it. And I think the other thing would be that I'm not, yeah, I'm just not scary. I'm really not a scary person. It's not something, I'm not dangerous, and I'm not someone who would harm anybody. When I get into a really bad state and my hallucinations become out of control, my harm goes inward. And it also goes physically towards myself, never towards the outer experience, never towards people outside of myself. And that might be just special to me. I think that DID holds a lot of self-hatred for a lot of people. Do I know all my parts yet? Mm-mm. No. And I don't think I ever will, to answer that question. I don't think I ever will. I think integration is something that will come, but with 52 parts, I may only integrate 20, and I may always exist with 20 parts. I have a lot of goals and aspirations, but right now my goal and aspiration in the next 5 years is to get better so that I can start to work on the real life goals. And then I guess the last question I will answer today is, how do your parts react to life changes and body changes? So for example, this is tattoo. It's one of them is really badly scarred. The other one is not. So there's Don't Panic, which is either from Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy, but actually I got Don't Panic on my arm because when I am in a situation out in public and I have nobody around me and I'm alone, I can look at that and it says Don't Panic and I can read it. So that's a constant reminder for me personally. And then also the semicolon is a representation of mental health, awareness in certain communities, and the story doesn't end kind of thing. So that's pretty normal. Changing my hair really, really happens a lot. Because I don't ever feel my identity is correct in any hair color because I have somebody inside. So, the ones I seem to be most comfortable in either brown or red hair. But blonde is what I've always wanted, but it doesn't seem to fit me anymore. I don't know. I also have such a strange experience with blonde hair. So yeah. So yeah, I think that's all I'm going to answer for today. I will make a second video soon, and I will talk to you guys later. Bye.